Hey there, this is a Yone Count video intended to fill you in on everything you need to know to deal with Yone when he's on the opposite team. If there's a champion you find yourself struggling with in your solo queue games and you're tired of banning it, then feel free to drop a comment and let us know. If you're interested in learning more about Yone or any other champion, then head on over to the Mobile Leagues website where you can see everything you need to know, including builds, combos, pro builds, tips, and more. So first off, what does Yone do? Yone is a high mobility assassin focused on diving and exterminating his foes. Yone's kit allows him to dive backlines, burst them down, and retreat back to his original position. He also has great teamfight potential with his AoE CC ultimate. Now let's talk about his specific strengths and weaknesses. Yone's main strength is his high mobility and damage. He has the ability to dive entire teams to assassinate high priority targets and then get away for free due to his soul and bound ability. He also has very high sustain and self-healing late game due to itemization choices and how they complement his kit. Yone is a resourceless champion, so he doesn't have to worry about restrictions due to mana or energy. Now looking at his weaknesses, he has a weak early game and is pretty vulnerable to ganks. Yone can be predictable due to his E. Although he can recast it early, he can't prevent the inevitable return and you will always know where he'll return to. Yone is also very item reliant and needs time to ramp up. We're going to dive in specifically how to counter Yone, but first is an overview of the major tips that we'll be breaking down further in this video. First is to play around his E. When Yone is diving with his E, he has to return to his original location. Try to stall it out and survive so that we will time out and return to his E. Alternatively, you can punish him by hitting him in his return location. Next is to be mindful of his Q3. Yone relies on a dash from his charge Q for most of his trades and all in combinations. Respect him when it's up. Remember his mixed damage. Yone's abilities and auto attacks deal mixed damage, so remember to itemize against this. Every other auto attack deals magic damage. His W and ultimate deal an even split of both damage types, and the detonation as E does true damage. Make sure to build a healthy mix of resistances. Don't stack up. Yone's ultimate will collect his opponents and group them together while dealing a good chunk of damage. He can then follow up that with his W to gain a huge shield, as it does more if he hits multiple champions. Time your CC correctly. Yone can't be CC'd once he starts casting his ultimate, so make sure not to waste your abilities during this period. Additionally, remember that if you CC him when his E is active, it'll prevent him from pressing it again to return or prolong it into giving you more time to kill him. If you're going into a game against a Yone, those are solid bases to remember and will help you be successful. It's always good to think about when a champion is strongest or weakest. Yone is strongest in the mid game when he has his mythic item, his boots and his infinity edge. When he has these, he gets an insane power spike due to having 100% crit from his passive. Yone is weakest early game, especially against high range champions that can poke and punish him. Handling Yone's early game is important as it's the best time to look to punish him. So how do you deal with him? First off, abuse his low range. Yone struggles in the early lane phase, especially pre-6 due to his low range and predictability. Try to harass and poke him down early on, forcing him back to gain an experience and gold advantage before he can get to his power spike in the mid game. Punish his E. When Yone is looking to fight or flight, he'll likely use his E first. Try to save your cooldowns and use them when he returns to his E, especially if you have skill shot nuke abilities. This can be a great way to counter him in trades. Don't let him dive. Don't let Yone push you under turret as this allows him to seek diving opportunities. Try to keep the minions in the middle of the lane so that they aren't at risk of ganks, but also deny him from a chance to dive in the process. Watch his Q stacks. Every third Q will allow Yone to dash forward and knock you up. Time your poke and trades around this cooldown and this will reduce his trade potential significantly. If Yone misses his ability, he doesn't have any escape pre-6 without his E. Next, let's take a look at his mid game. First off, you want to protect your high value targets. In the mid game, Yone will have a ton of damage and be looking to dive in and assassinate your carries. Whether that's you or your allies, make sure to peel Yone away and keep those carries alive. Yone's effectiveness is massively dampened versus high peel champions. Next, punish his E. As we know, as good as Yone's E is, it can be his downfall. If you manage to escape his dive attempt in the mid game fights, make sure to throw yourself at his E's original location and look to burst him down when he returns. Catch him out. When playing against high damage assassins like Yone, you'll want to look to catch them out first before any fight opportunities break out. Whether you kill him or just simply burn his major cooldowns, this can be key to weakening the opposition before a major objective. Taking away Yone's ultimate makes him a lot easier to deal with in any fight. When going into the late game against Yone, you want to avoid choke points. Yone can really benefit from choke points with a good ultimate. Try to avoid clustering up with your teammates in the jungle as this can lead to a pretty nasty ult opportunity, especially when combined with other team fighting ultimates. Time your exhaust and CC. Late game Yone is insanely hard to deal with due to his crazy scaling and consistent damage. Timing your exhaust to CC and bursting him down before he can pop off is your best option. Watch your flank. Yone will often look to get behind you with a good ultimate and stack you up for his teammates. Try to ward out the flanks and constantly gather information on where Yone is so you can prepare for any fights. Finally, let's take a look at some of the itemization options we have against Yone. First up, you want to have mixed resistances. Yone has a healthy amount of damage in both physical and magical due to several of his abilities, as we mentioned earlier in this guide. Make sure you're not leaving yourself vulnerable by not buying any armor or magic resist. Next up is Serpent's Fang, the anti-shield item. This is a great item against Yone, as most of the time he will purchase an immortal shield bow and he also gains a shield from his W. Next is anti-heal. This is probably the most important one versus Yone, as he has an insane amount of healing due to his items working well with his kit. Every time you're versus Yone, make sure you're investing into some anti-heal. Zhonya's or Stopwatch. The immunity can be pivotal in any lane phase or teamfight scenario against Yone, as he loves to dive. Try to catch him out with a well-timed immunity and turn the odds back in your favor. And finally, Guardian Angel. This can make or break in late game teamfights with Yone. If he uses all of his cooldowns and potentially his life to take you down, and you just get straight back up again. That wraps everything up for our Yone counter video. If you enjoyed this video, then you can find more counter videos on our website or in the playlist link below, and be sure to subscribe to be alerted for when we cover a new champion. Thanks for watching, and we look forward to seeing you again.